work for footwork, kicking the ball till it's done. We call Jussie's Giants. Football's just a branch of science. Hit the ball now, Jussie calls.
Jussie's Giants.
Defend the boring giant. Put your faith in Jussie's Giants. Next to kid, we're gonna win.
Jussie's Giants.
Buy your own paper, Sunshine.
Mr. Blair, I've been asked to request your presence in the back room.
Who wants my presence?
Mr. Lanigan, it seems that your account with us is in something of a mess. I'd advise you to cooperate.
You tell Mr. Lanigan. I haven't got time to talk to him now. I've got my own business to look after.
Our business involves £200, Mr. Blair. I'd advise you to step inside.
And I'd advise you to change your line of work, kidder. A heavy. You're a heavy. I've seen more meat on a jockey's whip.
We're going to murder those debts on Saturday. I promised myself a hat full of goals.
I hope so. Has Jussie given you pep talk yet? All that didn't do this, didn't do that.
Well, no, he hasn't. A bit worried about him, in fact.
Why?
I can't quite put my finger on it. Remember on the coach coming back from Newcastle?
Mm?
You were like a balloon full of helium. Well, considering the actual state you were in then, and a chance of getting revenge on the debts on Saturday, well, I'd say a bit of his bottle had gone.
Size 5.
Not Mighty Mouse again.
I well understand that you are a headstrong person, Mr. Blair, but facts are facts.
Now, look,
you owe us £200. Now, I can see £100 worth of boots and trainers and tracksuits and shirts. Well, there's another 100 there.
You mean sell off me stock? But if I tried raising 200 quid that way, I'd lose me business. I'm only just making headway as it is.
That's your problem, I'm afraid, Mr. Blair.
Can I not pay by instalments? Say, 50 quid now, and the rest when things improve?
I'm afraid not, Mr. Blair. Mr. Lanigan wants the full 200 by Monday. You see, he's a businessman too.
So all the work I've put in with me benefit money from Newcastle to start this shop has gone down the drain.
Happens to the best of people these days, Mr. Blair.
Ah, like your boss, you mean.
I am only the bearer of tidings, Mr. Blair. 200 by Monday. Good afternoon.
Johnny the runner always did say, never deal with two bookies at the same time.
It's going to be a great night, Jussie. Wait till the lads see these trophies. Great mementos of our first season. Go on, feel them, eh? Great gear, eh? Fell off the back of a lorry.
If I scratch it, will I find chocolate underneath?
Nope, 100% plastic. Now, the disco. Just so happens I can lay my hands on the turntable, the lights, the full Monty from a pal of mine for next to nothing. Oh, I'm waiting till you hear this. It's your kooky booky Bob the Gob doing the patter and spinning the platters.
Another one of your amazing talents, eh, Bob?
Oh, I've done it for Rotary, the golf club, and the round table.
And Lancelot and the lads walked out, I suppose.
Hey? I see you're warming to the idea, Joswell. Well, I'll lay on pop, sandwiches, sausages on sticks, tickets a fiver each.
A fiver?
Well, overheads, Jossie, overheads. I'll cover myself, of course.
Of course.
But think of the profit to the club.
Anything you like, Bob.
I don't know what's the matter with you, Jossie, old son. But hope you cheer up before the cup final.
I'll try, Bob, I'll try. Sometimes there's more to life than football.
There's what?
Right, Ross, give me the ball. Des. Right, gather round. Now then, I think one of the reasons the Dets beat us the other day was because they actually headed the ball. Now, we'll just refer you to Law 17, Roman numeral, subsection 3, referring to areas of use of the body above the Adam's apple, namely the cranium.
What's that?
Your head.
I've never read that law.
Now, well, this only refers to football played under Geordie rules, OK?
Yeah. Yeah.
Right, former Q, flying headers. Ricky, Selly, ball retrievers.
Come
on, Rick. Right, son. Good one. Hard and low makes it hard to save. Right, Barry? Plenty of power. Right, save for you, Harvey. Good save, son. Right, Stephen. Right, give us the ball.
There. Albert, take over for a minute, will you? I've got to see a man about a horse.
Right, come on, lads. Let's get on with it.
I told you. His mind's not 100% on Saturday's game.
I'll give you this, lad. You're a trier. What's your gaffer want now? Blood?
Oh, no, Mr. Blair. Mr. Lanigan has sent me on an errand of mercy.
I'll bet.
Yes, you probably will. Over and over again. As you know, Mr. Lanigan is a sporting man.
Alligator wrestling fan, is he?
And it just so happens that Mr. Lanigan has a nephew playing for the Detonators against you on Saturday.
And?
And Mr. Lanigan has placed a private wager of £200 with a friend that the Detonators win.
No way. Anyway, what kind of fella strikes wagers on little kiddies' football?
The point is, Mr. Blair, this could be your salvation. If you persuade your Giants to lose, then we will forget the £200 you owe.
You want me to throw a football match? A cup final?
Precisely. There'll be no more deadlines. Your business will be intact.
What about me pride?
Not a phrase I've ever seen on a balance sheet.
No, you check your boss. I will not throw the match. And if he sacks you, I hear they need a bouncer down at the nursery school.
You've got to be kidding, boss. He's like the black hole of Calcutta in there.
Oh, Joswell.
Hey,
he's not actually smart, is he? You know, you get a luxury country table lamp and tell it on there, big day.
This is the best you are getting, though. Get in.
Right.
Jeez. Oh, get up. No, watch
right, now, mind your fingers.
Yeah, Joswell.
Like 20 minutes to go. We'll have to get changed here.
Don't be daft, we'll get chucked off.
Nobody chucks me or my team off a bus. Now get changed, sharpish.
Right. Now then. From the back. Harvey, I want you like a rock, son.
Right, boss.
Now, whenever possible, roll the ball out to Ricky along the ground.
Now, first, please.
Wait, I want you as often as possible. Get the first, son.
Oh.
2 and 12 halves to Wennington Green, please.
£2.40.
And then...
Well, well, well.
Yep.
Team coach in the garage, having each new old panelling fitted, is it, sir, man?
I thank you not to interrupt my tactics talk. Now, Glenn and Sally.
Yes, boss.
I don't really just think about striking. Jockey them when they've got the ball.
Right,
just
boss.
A minute, Mark, just a minute. Don't... Are those two your strikers, then?
Fine, what's it to you?
And you're telling them to jockey the opposition? You're talking through your bonnet. Strikers should hang about in space and look for good positions. Only an idiot would tell them to a jockey.
What are you calling an idiot? And what do you know about football anyway?
Listen, Surrey. I am a Stretford Ender of some 15 years standing. And I mean standing. And I am calling you an idiot.
Now, hang on a minute, the both of you. There's no need to get ratty. This clip, you need to clip round the lug hole.
Now, look, Mr. Manager. Apart from filling these kids' heads with rubbish about football, you are disturbing the peace of my bus. So unless you go downstairs and behave yourself, I might be forced to put you off.
I think he's right, Jossie. I'll finish the briefing.
Aye, you'll talk more sense than this Geordie. Bottom deck, pal.
£12.20.
Albert, Tracy, take it in the change room. Then get on the pitch as quick as you can. Right, Liz. OK, what now, Mr. Blair?
It would be in your best interests to follow me.
I don't get you, sir. Here we are, raring to go, and he slopes off.
Never mind. Keep your head, will you?
Right.
Ross, run the legs off him. Don't be selfish.
Look, clever clogs. Oh, let's get stuck in, lads. Santa Claus.
How's it going at the match, son? No score. The debt's piling on the pressure. The Giants are all at sixes and sevens. What a pity.
You're wasting your time, Lanigan. My lads won't lose this. I've got them trained, tempered like steel.
It doesn't sound like you have, Jossie. Does it, Goliath?
Look, I only came on this ride to make it clear to you that I will not throw the match. Anyway, I think it's disgusting. Grown men betting on lads' football.
Let me tell you that my private wager is with one of your club's biggest supporters.
Oh, I might have known. Could one of his ancestors have been an admiral with one eye? A fellow who reckoned he could see no ships?
Hello. What's happening? The debts are up, eh? The Giants' goalkeeper, overexcited. The Giants getting up each other's noses. Fancy that. Right. We'll drive you back. If you agree to have a word with your lads and tell them just to forget the match.
I will not make my lads throw a game away, even if I have to lose the shop and go on the social.
Your choice, pal.
Two rotten nerdles serving goals upon a plate.
You should have called for the ball.
What were you lost stampeding round like a herd of buffalo? Fat chance I had.
Ross is right. You should have made it yours.
Oh, I see. Stupid me. So that's why you and Sally scored. To teach me a lesson. Well, there's the gloves. Go and goal yourself.
Just like the old days, eh? All blaming each other. If Jossie was here, he'd soon have you.
Oh, Jossie! Our dear devoted manager!
He's got a lot on his mind right now.
Yeah, horses. He's probably found a new betting shop to chuck his money away in.
Yeah,
but on cup final day. Mm. Who's going to take you to the ball now, Cinder? Prince Charming's done a runner.
..15 minutes of the second half gone. Bad mistake in the Giants midfield. My nephew in possession. It's a goal. 3-0. It's a stroll. You know, it looks like your lads can't do it without you, Jossie. But you had your chance to pay off in installments.
No. I want that 200 on Monday. Or quite a bit of stock has to go.
Right. Do you think we should let him go now, Goliath?
Certainly, boss. I'm sure his lads will have a few questions to put.
On your bike, Mr. Manager. Up your nose muscles.
Thank you. minutes to go. No chance.
Come on, the Giants! Giant! Giant! Get stuck in, lads!
Oh. Sorry, Albert. You know, I never reckoned they needed Jossie, but without him, there's just a collection of odds and bods. Where the flipping heck is he?
You know Jossie. He's out chasing rainbows somewhere, probably.
Away the lads! Come on, the Giants! It's not over yet! What's the damage, Pet? Still 3-0, is it?
Damage? You've ruined our greatest day. And you talk about damage? Just a minute. How do you know the score when you haven't been here?
Well, I was kind of delayed by a pillar of our community, one Jed Lanigan, bookmaker of this parish, and I believe a friend of yours, Bob.
No. Yes. How do you mean, delayed?
Well, I owe him a bit of cash, as it happens.
A bit?
200 quid, to be exact. But the reason he and his 6-stone heavy have been sitting on me for most of the afternoon is that he stands to win 200 quid on a bet if we lose. Now, I don't suppose you know anybody who would wager 200 quid with Lanigan on a young lad's football match, Bob.
Well, it was more of a gentleman's bet. Nothing serious.
Serious enough for them to hijack me?
Sorry, Jossie. I didn't think Lanigan was that big a rat.
Grab your bucket and sponge, love. I think our lads need a bit of a pep talk.
How can you do anything now? There's only 10 minutes to go.
Just watch this, son. Giants! Giants! Ricky! 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 Oh, man down, ref! Harvey, get in here! Now, look!
Now, I know what you're thinking. That I dipped out on you on the big day. Well, I admit my disappearance was largely my own fault. Me betting has got us into trouble again.
How's it going in there? Is it badly hurt?
No, I'm just massaging his leg a little. I think he'll live. But right now, I've got about 9 minutes to sort this lot out. Now, I'm not going to tell you how. You should know by now. Just remember what Bobby Charlton told you the other day. The cup is about heart and flair and never giving up. Now, go and run the debts off the feet.
Yeah, come on, lads. Come on.
Tactics in there, Jossie Blair. I'm going to report you to the league.
What would I know about tactics, Les? I'm just massaging a few muscles and a few egos, just giving my lads a boost.
Remember the Charlton spirit, lads. Now, come on now. 5 minutes to go, lads. Let's see if we can get those other two. Come on now, lads. Back you come. Come on, lads. Go on, Massam. Run at the Ross.
Come on, Sally.
He'll try!
He will! We're in it, Logan. It's a penalty shootout now. 5 shots each side, OK?
We're still in with a chance. 3-2. 4-3 to the Giants.
Right now, Harvey, concentrate. Save this and we've won the cup.
guys and gals, giants and giantesses. Just to remind you what we're all celebrating here tonight, a truly great and momentous cup victory by a team I am proud to be associated with, a team of winners. Let's hear it for the Glipton Giants! Now, hitters and glitters, finger popping daddies, heroes and villains, holes and fillies, the platter that matters, the rave from the grave, the blast from the past. In fact, I'm thinking of booking this for the Glipton Community Centre.
Get it
over there! All right, it's Cliff Richard and the young ones.
Oh, come on, doll, let's get razzing. The one that cup, where's the party spirit?
Look, I've discovered today why Jossie's been acting so strange lately. If he doesn't pay Lanigan, the bookie, the money he owes him by Monday, Lanigan's going to take all the stock from Magpie Sports.
You mean... But just you to business.
Exactly. And if he goes out of business...
We close up. What for? We've got to sort some out fast, girl. Hey, you lot, come here. What's the matter?
I'm sorry about the Newcastle mix-up, Pet. We've got my wires crossed. I hope we can remain friends.
Oh, honestly, Jossie, if that's the way you treat your friends, I feel sorry for your enemies. I mean, after all, I did pay for the trip and help to save your ground.
Shall we shake on it?
I've got a better idea.
I've asked Bob the Gob to put us down for a couple of snowies at the end. And Tracy, I'm going to put you down for the twist, if you know what that is.
I watch old films, Daddy-o. And I've seen my mum doing it at parties.
Them lot going to be doing formation limbo dancing, then?
So, you going to strut your funky stuff, boss?
Yeah, move to the groove, counsellor.
No, I don't think so. We shall have to take things a bit easy. Jossie's a bit old to boogie on down.
Hey, watch it. Come on, let's dance.
Now, what's this deputation all about? I'm neglecting my public.
Dad, get your image for a tick. Look, you've made a comfy little profit out of this disco.
So?
So, there's a lot you can do with the £100 from tonight and the 200 Lanigan drop your way.
How do you know about that?
Look, Dad, if Jossie doesn't give Lanigan the 200 notes that he owes him, we lose a great manager. But if a kind person who's just come into the Reddies makes a gesture...
It would be good for the club.
Yeah.
Good for my image.
Yeah.
Very good for Jossie.
Yeah.
And one right in the eye for Jed Lanigan.
Yeah, that and all, Dad.
Hurry up, lads. They're about to start the presentation.
Oh, come on, lads. Presentation's great.
Silence for the manager of Glipton Giants. Yay!
When I first met you lot, there were too many prima donnas, not enough Maradonnas. Joking aside, this is one of the proudest moments of my life. And I want to make three special presentations to three very special people. First, to the man who started the Grasshoppers, now the Giants, my pal, Albert Hansen. And secondly, to a gentleman and a friend who has supported the club financially in this first year, Bob Nelson. Yay! And finally, to a lassie who has supported me and the club through thick and thin, Tracy Gaunt.
We now have a little surprise for our manager. Here is a small gift, which, thanks to the generosity of Mr. Bob Nelson, will allow Mr. Blair to solve a little problem he's been having with his sports business.
When I was injured and had to leave Newcastle United, I thought I was leaving the biggest bunch of friends a man could ever make. Well, I was wrong. This club has brought me more fun, pride and achievement than a man could ever dream of. This'll keep the wolves from the door.
Till the flat racing season starts.
And all of you, I promise a better, brighter, more successful season next year.
Jossie knows where they are going.
Now it's St. James's Park. Your turn next to watch the strip. One thick ear or one fat lip. Tackle hard and do your best. Just get out there and leave the rest. Hit your Jossie's Giants. Football's just a branch of science. Hit the ball now, Jossie goes.
Jossie's Giants!
Dependable.
Destroyer by Three Lens from Romeo's Revenge and A Bell
Hung
Behind, Midnight Folly.
Romeo's
Revenge.
I can't understand it. 20-1. It looked a sure thing.
Midnight Folly, 9-4. There's an objection to the winner at red car. It's been upheld. Artist Destroyer is disqualified. The winner is Romeo's Revenge.
Justice! Justice!